Hi Salim, how have you been? How has the lockdown been treating you?
Actually, it's been not as bad as you think it would be, or for a lot of people, it's been pretty, it's been a little bit depressing. It's been a little bit, but not for us, not for me at all. I've been very, active, and we've developed a great way of working from home. So basically, last year we worked on an album called Bhoomi 2020. Now, this was recorded last year, and it was filmed in January, and we were supposed to mix it in March. When second week of March happened, and coronavirus thing started getting a little, kind of, it started getting very active, in our part of some parts of India. And I think I had a feeling that this may get a little crazy, and we may need to be working from home or something like that. And that's exactly what happened. But we had done Suleiman and me had done our homework, and there's a software which we figured where my engineer could play from his home studio, the computer, and me, Suleiman, and another co-worker, Raj Pandit, could listen to it in our headphones real time without any lag, without any quality loss. And then for communication, we had Skype, so we were communicating, discussing our levels and our mixes and what should go up, what should come down. When you're mixing a song, you need to discuss all that, right?
Right.
So that was happening over Skype. 13 or 14 days, we were just busy mixing our album. Post that, I used to go on, like different news channels, as we did a little program for PM Cares. And that was I did a little section as part of a concert called Sangeet Setu. Another thing which I really valued was I've been working out twice a day, so that my fitness levels are really high up. You started with a question, and I'm giving you all the answers. Last week, we started, Suleiman and me started an initiative as part of our NGO, which is called Zaria. Since 2 years, we've started this organization called Zaria, which creates opportunities and supports folk musicians, especially musicians in Rajasthan, in areas of Jaisalmer and Barmer. I discovered them a few years ago, and just when we experienced their magic, me and Suleiman decided to take them on tour with us. So we went to the United States, we went to Canada, we went to UK, UAE, Singapore, Russia. So many different countries. We even performed at NH7 with these Mangania folk singers, and it's incredible. A couple of years later, because we had traveled with them a lot, we started creating opportunities for them so that they could get their own gigs, and they could go. And their livelihood is very, very basic, and they come from very remote areas, and they need that support. Some months are not good because their entire livelihood is based on tourism. Besides certain very few private gigs, you know that tourism is not the best right now. We started supporting them, with financially. We started like giving them some aid, some help. Still trying to create opportunities for them. But this last 3 months has been terrible for these guys. So Suleiman and me have started a fundraiser as a donation for people to come and donate on a site like on a keto site as a fundraiser. And we're supporting 100 families of these folk musicians.
If you look at the trend right now, the trend is to, pick up a classic, add some fast beats and, create a remix. What do you have to, say about this trend? Are you, a supporter of this?
Absolutely not. Look, it's very simple. If you are making a remake for a purpose, let's say you are making Dilli 6 again. Okay, and you're calling it Dilli 8. You're Dilli now. Just, whatever. And it's a continuation to the story where Rakesh Mehra left. Dawn mein, they used Ye Mera Dil Pyar Ka Deewana, but it had purpose. Shankar Ehsaan Loy and Farhan Akhtar used Ye Mera Dil Pyar Ka Deewana. It had purpose because they were making the same, they were making Dawn with a different narrative. But the songs, there are certain songs which could have been just like Hai Ke Paan Banaras Wala. It was there in the film, in the New Dawn. But it makes sense to have that song. you are making a completely different film, and then you're using an iconic song as like Masakali. Like, no connection at all. No connection at all. So if there's purpose, I'm okay with it. But if there is no purpose, you're just randomly picking up a song because you own the rights to it as a publisher, as a record label, and remaking and destroying it. That's like, I'm absolutely... Don't we have enough talent in our country? And that's my pinned tweet, by the way. You can check it out. Don't we have enough talent in our country that we need to, you know, focus to make new music rather than going back and destroying someone else's classic? No need. Absolutely no need. A lot of people have flagged me and Suleiman, which I must tell you, I must confess. Sometime back, Suleiman and me made a musical, remade a musical called Umra Ujaan. Now, Umra Ujaan, we followed the book. We didn't follow the film. We followed the book, which is written by Haji Mirza Haji Ruswa. But the Khayyam Saab's music was unbelievable in that film, right? So we used the music, but we had the purpose, because the story of Umra Ujaan and Nawab Sultan and the entire screenplay is the same. We followed the book, but the story is pretty much the same. And the music of Khayyam Saab is so amazing and mind-blowing that we decided that we'll use Khayyam Saab's music and give it proper love. Not change anything. Not change a single piece of lyric. Not change a single piece of interlude. Give it proper respect and love, because we were anyway making a classic which was back set in the early 19th century in Lucknow. We didn't need to change and add beats to the music. So we had purpose. Now we are making Disco Dancer, which is, you know, the very famous musical Mithunda and Bappi Lahiri and whatever. So we are remaking that with Saregama, and we've done I Am a Disco Dancer, and Saregama decided that we should release this as a single with Tiger Shroff, and a lot of people flagged us like, oh, Saleem Suleiman are remaking again. But we have purpose to do it. We're remaking Disco Dancer, the whole entire story with Mithunda and the mother, and Oberoi, who's a character, everything is the same. We're just re-bringing the 80s era to stage, to theater. So if there is purpose to remake, surely. If there is no purpose, why? No need.
Right. So, last year you also talked about how in the music industry, there is an issue of royalties. You named, two big players. You named Yash Raj and you named T-Series. And you said that they've been pocketing the royalties, but not really giving it to the creators involved in making the songs. So, has that scenario changed? What is the update on that?
So let me correct you. I never said anything like that. I don't know who picked it up. I don't know who wrote it. I know there was Twitter was, what Twitter is all about. Twitter just keeps throwing things, and and that's why I never gave any kind of retweet or any kind of like or any kind of comment to it. Because today, anyone can say anything. There are a million fake things which happen on WhatsApp. There are a million fake things what happen. I can't keep like certifying, hey, maine nahi kaha, maine nahi bola. People can say anything and then print it and put it, But yes, there is a claim, which not me, I'm not doing that. IPRS, which is the Indian Performing Rights Society, which is a body which is officially appointed to collect royalties, is demanding royalties for composers and lyricists, basically writers and, composers, for the money that Yash Raj and T-Series owes them from 2012 till now. So the copyright law was amended in 2012 with Javed Akhtar ji making that historic speech in Rajya Sabha, and then post that the law changed and it got these rules applied that that the royalty share, the performance royalties, need to be shared with the composer and the writer. Something that IPRS is in talks with them. I am nobody to say anything. I'm just a member of IPRS. But because, somebody had to put my name onto it, they did it. And I didn't say any comment. But right now, just for the record, since you're asking me, I'm saying this, that this is not from me. It's from IPRS. IPRS is in conversation with Yash Raj and is in conversation with T-Series. And I'm sure they will find some success there.
So you were not the one who made the comment that I have not worked with them for the last 4 years, and you know I've moved on to other labels because.
So I did an interview just like this, and you know I wish it was a video interview just like this, but it wasn't. It was a telephonic interview, and you know it was with a publication, and you know a very popular publication, and they obviously asked me that, you know, why, how come you haven't worked with Yash Raj since 4 years? I said they haven't worked with me. I'm always ready to work with them. You know, they've. I guess the time will come when they want to work with me. They'll call me and they'll work with me. We've done so many movies. Chak De, Aaja Na Chale, Neel and Nikki, you know, Pyar Impossible. My God, Roadside Romeo. So many, like Rocket Singh. I don't know. Like, I've just, there are loads of films we've done. Rab Ne Bana Di Jodi. So, you know, whenever they want to work with me, they can always call me, and they can, and it's, they haven't done that for a long time. That doesn't mean I say that, oh, you know, they, like, they haven't worked with me because I'm asking them for royalties. No, I've never asked them. It's not my job to ask them. In any case, the body that will collect royalties will be IPRS. I will not collect it. They will collect it on our behalf. And when I say our, not just Suleiman and my behalf, but everyone's behalf. And then they'll distribute it. That's how it goes. We have no, like, no bad, you know, kind of like relations or bad feelings with anyone. I mean, this is a process between companies and between royalty societies and the company. And they are in conversation. They will work it out. It's not just me and Suleiman. There's so many writers and composers, you know, that have worked with Yash Raj and will continue to, and with T-Series.
Right. So, you know, you started this discussion by saying that you've been working on Bhoomi, which is, I think, a follow-up to your first ever independent album, which
Absolutely.
Was 2 decades ago.
And it's a full
circle. I see a piano. Is that a piano in the background?
I think so, yeah.
So, could you play something for us?
This interview can be really long then.
I don't think that should be a problem. Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
It's been great, great talking to you.
Thank you, Samandi.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Speak soon. Bye.
Bye-bye.